everybody, for coming. Welcome to 2002 University of Toledo Football Signing Day. In just a few minutes, we'll bring out Coach Campbell, or a few moments, actually, to talk about the class in general. He'll introduce the staff, and we'll get to see some great highlights of this tremendous class and tremendously large class. And Coach Campbell's going to tell you all about it, as will our assistants. Just a few things. We do have a women's basketball game afterward, the game, so we're going to try to move this along just as quickly as we can, so that we can finish up here and make room for a basketball game tonight. So hope that you can make the game as well. Okay, let's bring out Coach Campbell. Coach Campbell, if you want to come out. This is Coach's first recruiting class. Thank you. Give a hand. And by all accounts, a great class, and Coach is going to tell you all about it. Coach?
Well, first of all, thank you guys for coming. What a great day to be at Toledo Rocket. And we couldn't be more excited about announcing this class and this and the student-athletes we're about to bring here to the University of Toledo. I'm really proud of it. And, you know, before I get started, what I'd like to do is I'd like to talk a little bit about what our philosophy is in recruiting and what we're looking for in a young man that we bring to the University of Toledo. And for us, it really starts out pretty simple. It's three core values that we believe in and that we've really strived to evaluate in this process. And the first thing is getting young men with tremendous character. And I know sometimes that's cliche and sometimes people talk about that, but we work so hard to evaluate the character of the young man that we bring to the University of Toledo. And we evaluate character really in three ways. We evaluate the character of the young man on the football field. When we get video and we study the video and we go to the football games, we want and we evaluate how hard does that young man play? Does he fit what we're going to ask that young man to do on a day-to-day basis? And so we talk so much, and we talk about as a staff, does this guy fit who we want to be and what we want to show on the field on Saturdays? Two is character in the classroom. Does a young man value and understand the value of a Toledo education? Is he willing to go the extra mile and be successful in the classroom? And is he committed to doing it? So that's the second way. And then the third thing in character that we do is I think we do a great job of as a staff, is we go into these young men's high school and we talk to either the cafeteria lady, we talk to one of their teachers, the security guard, the secretary. We find out what's the character of this young man in the community. Is this somebody that we want to bring in? Because I think one of the great things that you guys know here today is what the University of Toledo stands for. And right now, what the University of Toledo's football program stands for, and it's second to none in anywhere in the country. And so character is the pinnacle piece of the puzzle when we go in to evaluate a young man. Number two is passion for the game of football. I think being a young guy, not going through this process so long ago, what you find out is so many people in recruiting want to tell these young guys how easy it is. But I think we're the first one as a staff and as a head football coach, and we're going to tell them what the challenges are. It's a 365-day-a-year commitment to being the best student-athlete you can be on a day-to-day basis. And we're going to ask and demand the world of you. And I want young men that want that challenge and want to be part of that. And what kind of passion and energy do they have? And so that's big for us in the recruiting process. And the last thing is finding that same young man that has the characteristic of commitment to excellence in the classroom. He takes that same drive and passion and energy to being the best football player he can become. And we want to find those people that have that same drive and commitment to excellence in the classroom. And I think, you know, at the end of the day, for these young men to get a four-year scholarship at the University of Toledo, it's somewhere right around $195,000. And does that young man understand the opportunity that he has to better his life and his family's life and give himself one of the greatest opportunities of the world is to come out of here? It's our job as a football staff to come out of here as the best young man he can become. And so those three areas of great character, great passion for the game of football, and a commitment to excellence in the classroom. Those are the foundations of what we're recruiting on here at the University of Toledo. And what I'm excited to talk to you guys about today more than anything is to show you these young guys and why we really feel these guys fit that to a T. This is a class that I think a little bit about the process. This is a year, it was a record-setting year for us. We had over 1,400 student-athletes on our campus. So of the young men going back to junior day last year, going to spring practice, going into the summer camps, either the ones we had right here on the campus at the University of Toledo or the ones that we carry throughout the state and up in Michigan, or the young men that come to the football games on Saturdays here at the University of Toledo, and then with official visits, we had over 1,400 prospective student-athletes here on our campus. And for us, the opportunity to evaluate those young men, to make sure we were finding the right piece of the puzzle that was so big for us and so exciting for us. And so I was really excited about that opportunity. And at the end of the day, we have 27 scholarship signees to talk about today. We have four tremendous preferred walk-ons. And at the end of the day, we have the opportunity to talk about 31 student-athletes to you guys today and announce that. And we're really excited about it. That two of those young men are junior college football players. One of them's name is Brad Donovan, who is a junior college punter kicker who will actually be here and is actually enrolled right now on our campus and working with our football team. And then the other young man is a young man named Cameron Cole, who's a cornerback, and he will actually be starting here in May when he finishes his requirements at the junior college that he's at right now presently. Some fun facts about this program and about the young men coming in here is this. I think one of the first things that we try to evaluate with a student-athlete is the type of football program that a young man comes from. And we want to recruit winners. We expect and know how to win here at the University of Toledo. And what we want is young men that come from the same type of environment and the same type of program that we expect. And I think one of the things that I get to brag about today is we have seven young men that either competed or won in a state championship game in their career. We have 81 state playoff game appearances from the young men in our program coming in. And the biggest thing I can brag about is 25 of the 27 young men as seniors in their high school football program led their football team to winning records. So we take a lot of pride in the quality and the winning that these young men have already achieved. And I think now it's our job to take them to the next level. And I think when you recruit winners and guys that know how to win and be successful, and you bring them into a program that already knows how to win and be successful, you can take the next step as a football program. And I think we did that today in this class. Next, I think one of the facts that I love to talk about is what we call Rocket Nation. And when we came here as a staff 4 years ago, we said we are going to put a fence 4 hours from our campus around Rocket Nation, and we're going to keep the best student athletes right here at the University of Toledo. Well, it's a record-setting day in Toledo history because 24 of the 27 scholarship signees are from that four-hour radius. 24 of 27 student-athletes are right here from 4 hours radius from our doorstep, and we couldn't be more proud to have each and every one of those young men. Also, it's the fifth year in a row for us that we here at the University of Toledo have signed the City of Toledo, the Toledo Blade Player of the Year in Jody Webb from Whitmer High School. So we have taken a tremendous amount of pride in understanding not only what the local and area high school coaches put into building their high school football programs, but we have laid the foundation of making sure we keep the best players home and representing the University of Toledo, and we couldn't be more excited and proud of that fact. Third fun fact for everybody is one of the facts that I love to talk about maybe more than anything, is the pride and joy of the success of the student athlete that we're bringing here to the University of Toledo. This football team and this class will have a record-setting group of young men that we're actually bringing in here to the University of Toledo, an average of a 3.125 GPA coming into the University of Toledo. We're extremely proud of these guys. We're proud of the success they've had in the classroom, and we're proud of the success that they're coming into the number one team GPA in the Mid-American Conference, and that's the University of Toledo. Next fun fact, and I think it's one of the things that maybe I'm really proud about, and I'm proud about, I think there's a lot of people in here that will take great pride in this. Of the young men that we brought on our visit to our campus to have what we call an official visit, there were 45 young men that came in on official visit for a scholarship here at the University of Toledo. 27 of those young men said yes. That's a batting average well over 500. And it's well over 50% of the young men that come here to the University of Toledo that visit with not only myself, but our staff and the great contingency around our staff have said yes to Toledo. And here's a couple bragging points. I think one of the first things you notice when you bring a family and you bring people here to the University of Toledo, what these families say is they brag about the people. They brag about the community of Toledo and the support that you guys give us on a day-to-day basis. They brag about the great correlation and the great relationship between the academic community here at the University of Toledo and the athletic community. And I give so much praise to Dr. Jacobs and to Mike O'Brien for intertwining our faculty and staff here and our athletic community. It's one. And I think the parents and the players feel that. And it's something that I take great pride in. Number two is facilities. And I know so many people here have taken great pride in the facilities that we have. But I give Mike O'Brien and our athletic administration the vision and the goal that they have for making the University of Toledo the premier athletic facilities here in the Mid-American Conference and truly in the Midwest, when you have facilities like the Glass Bowl and the Press Box, when you have the Fetterman facility, when you have Savage Arena, and when you bring these people in and you talk about the wow factor. I think it instantly relates to any young man that comes here to the University of Toledo and gets to see that. And then from an academic piece of the puzzle, I think it's one of the great things. You come in and you see the image of this university from the bell tower to the University Hall to Stranahan Hall, right up to our engineering facilities with Nitschke Hall. And you see the cleanliness and you see the kindness of the people and the faculty and staff here at the University of Toledo and what the vision Dr. Jacobs has had for the university. I think people are in awe of what they see when they get on campus here at the university. And another thank you and another piece of the puzzle that I'm going to brag about today is I'm going to brag about our players. I think one piece of the puzzle when parents and families and young men come to the University of Toledo on an overnight visit, they get to hang with our players and be around our players. And I think one of the things that I've got such a great pride in and one of the things that I was so proud of to be the head football coach here at the University of Toledo has nothing to do with me. It has everything to do with the young men that we get to work with and coach on a day-to-day basis. And I think when parents and young recruits come in and meet our players, they're wowed. They're wowed by the quality of young man. They're wowed by what they stand for. They're wowed by their commitment to excellence in the classroom and to being the best football player and student athlete that they can become. I couldn't be more proud of our young men. And it's funny, before the bowl game even occurred, we had the majority of this recruiting class intact. And I know we went through a little bit of a change in a couple chaotic moments, but these our players are the guys that held this staff intact and this class intact. And I couldn't be more proud of them. And I think that when you see the quality of young man that we have and we put that product on a field and in the classroom on a day-to-day basis, I really couldn't be more proud of those guys. The last but not least, I want to talk about our coaches. And I think when you bring a family and you bring people to our campus, the first thing that they say is it's a wow factor with our coaching staff. I firmly believe we have truly the most loyal, the most dynamic, and truly the finest coaching staff in America right now. And I really couldn't be more proud of those guys and their commitment to stay at the University of Toledo, their commitment to stay with these young men, and their commitment to represent you in this great university. And I think before I even thank them, and I will as we go throughout this today, I have to say a special thank you to their wives. For all of you guys that know, recruiting season is kind of a season in its own right. And, you know, we as husbands can't be home a whole lot. And one of the great things that we have here is we do call it a Toledo Rocket football family. But it's our wives that make that happen. Our wives commit themselves to coming on weekends, to the official visit weekends. Our wives are as good a recruiters as we are. They almost work hand in hand with us through the entire process. And let me just give a thank you to these, to my great wife, Erica Campbell, to Caprice Rashid, Shelly Isferding, Whitney Hauser, Adrian Salon, Stephanie Watson, Lena Matukowicz, Sally Manning, and Julie Wade. These ladies have given up their time, have given up their husbands for the last 2 months. And as you guys know, the way to be successful in recruiting is outworking people. And they've given us the opportunity to do that, and they've worked hand in hand with us to make sure we bring the best quality young man here to the University of Toledo. So I really am. I've got great pride in that. And the last thank yous I'm going to give is to the high school coaches, and not only in Toledo, but the high school coaches in that four-hour radius. Because here's another great stat for us, 21 of the 27 signees that we signed here at the University of Toledo on signing day, Those young men attended our camps. And we had so many camps this year, from summer camp to traveling camp to right camps right here at the University of Toledo. And for those high school coaches to give their time and their commitment to letting their young men come and evaluate us as a coaching staff and let us evaluate them, I think that says a lot about the quality of high school coach and the quality of program that we have here in the Midwest. And so many thanks go out to them. A couple just quick stats that I'm going to talk about, and I'll get right into the production of letting you see some of our new staff members and me talking about this class, is all-star games. Well, I think one of the great products of a great high school career is for a young man to have the opportunity to play in an all-star game. And I want to talk about some of the elite all-star games here in the state of Ohio. We have six young men that will actually be competing in the North-South Ohio all-star game. We're really proud of that. This year we have four young men that will be competing in the Big 33 game. And for the first time in a long time, we have two young men that'll be on the Ohio team and two young men on the Pennsylvania team. So we're really proud of those young men. And for the first time, and maybe in the history of the University of Toledo, we actually get to announce our first signing of a Parade All-American. A young man named DJ Larkins from up in Detroit, Michigan, is a first-team Parade All-American. And we get the opportunity to talk about him and what you know about a Parade All-American. It's not just him being a great football player. It's him being a great community servant, him being a great student athlete, and we're really proud of what he brings to the table. So without me talking anymore, let me bring our great staff and introduce them. And actually, I'm going to start with our defensive staff. And the first guy that I'm going to bring up, and I'm going to introduce all of our staff members, is the new defensive coordinator here at the University of Toledo. This gentleman comes in with as an impressive resume as they get. He's a gentleman that's won and been in the postseason the last 9 years of his career. He's a gentleman that comes in with being a part of some of the stingiest defenses in America, and a gentleman that's going to bring and be the great face of Toledo Rocket defense, Mr. Tom Matukowicz.
Thanks, Matt. I just go by Coach Took. Even my wife calls me. I got one of those names in recruiting, got to shorten up right away. But my family and I are excited about joining your family and Rocket Nation. Couldn't be more excited. What I want to do right now is introduce the linebacker signing class. And this was a pivotal class. I mean, when you look at our roster, this class at linebacker really is a big deal. We're going to lose Moles and Bell, two really good football players next year. And you know, with Matt and the staff, I think they really crushed it this year. First guy I want to introduce is Chase Murdoch. I think they're going to put his photo up there. But this was a guy that was heavily recruited. Two teams that we will play next year fought for this guy, and it went down to the wire. And in fact, his fax was the last one to come in. I knew a lot about him. My wife and daughter ate a hot dog at his football game, so I saw him live, worked with him in a camp, and he is definitely the real deal. Lou did an outstanding job of recruiting him, and let's take a look at him on film. From the film, you could tell I'm pretty fired up. He was a tailback. He's definitely a high-end guy. The next guy I want to introduce to you guys is Jalen Coleman. And probably the best thing I can say about Jalen is the first time I watched that film, okay, I called Coach Candle to try to make out with him. I was extremely fired up. He's one of the best high school football players I've seen on film. One thing about Jalen now, he is electric on the field and probably just as electric off of it. He's got one of those personalities. When you meet him, you're going to love him. And he's a guy that's played on offense. He was a tailback, played on defense, very, very physical guy. He had, you know, multiple BCS scholarships laying in his trash at his house. His dad threw in for us. So we're excited about him. Let's check him out on film. Jalen Coleman.
It's a new day, bro. My day. Gotta do it now.
I'll leave you with this. I'm really excited about the future, and the future looks bright. And go Rockets.
The next guy for us I'm going to bring up has been the foundation of our success here at the University of Toledo on our defensive line. I think if you know football, you know if you're going to sustain success, you're going to have a great defensive line year in and year out. And this guy's been a great tutor for our guys. We were able to keep him right here locked in at the University of Toledo. And this gentleman, it will be the new run game coordinator and our defensive line coach, Coach Eli Rashid.
Thank you. Well, I'm truly fired up. I tell you, we got five defensive linemen coming in here. These guys have great size and great potential. And I'm going to get started with, first of all, Phil Martin. He's out of Chicago, Illinois. He's a 6'4" frame, 265 pounds. Now, by the time he comes in here this summer, he should be somewhere around 275, 280. Now, just a little bit about Phillip is that he had 12 sacks his senior year, 21 tackles for loss. Okay, he's also a pretty good shot putter, about 58 feet right now. Throws a disc at somewhere around 175. So he's very explosive. And the best thing about it is Phillip right now has a 28 SAT right now, ACT right now. So that's pretty good. Let's take a look at Phillip. Coach Ianni did a great job recruiting Phillip. Now, our plans for Phillip is for him to come in and play the three technique position. Now, we lost three guys there with Malcolm Riley, John Lamb, and Johnny Roberts. Those guys have great size, and we think Phillip can come in and help us right away. The next gentleman is Christopher Collins. He's out of Cleveland John Hay High School. Now, he's also a rangy kid at 6'3 and a half, about 260. He's going to play the defensive end. A little bit about Chris right now is that great family. Now, he has an older brother that played college ball. He has a sister that played volleyball. There's 10 kids in the family. has a younger brother now that's being recruited by us. We plan to recruit this family for a long, long time. Let's take a look up at Christopher right now. Three more left now. It's gonna get pretty good. The next gentleman here is Orion Jones. Now he's from Jinks High School in Tulsa, around Tulsa, Oklahoma. Now Orion's about 6'2". He's about 265. Now the thing that I'm gonna say about this, he was the defensive player of the year for his conference and district, which is almost unusual to be a defensive player of the year. But after you watch his highlight, you'll see why he was picked to be a defensive player of the year. Fourth inside guy that we went down to Tampa, Florida, Armwood High School, which won the state championship. Great, great high school. Alan Covington is about 6'2", 265, 270. And I talked about being a defensive player of the year. Here's another young gentleman that was an inside guy who was the defensive player of the year for the 6A classification, which is the largest in the state of Florida. That's pretty good. Let's take a look at his highlight. Last, we call this guy Big Daddy, Trayvon Hester out of Pittsburgh, PA, Penn Hills High School. Big fella, 6'3", 285 pounds. All I gotta say is watch the film. I can't get those guys to play, Coach Campbell, you might need your new defensive line coach. I'm going to have fun coaching these guys. This group is potentially the best in the MAC. And you're going to see great things out of our defensive front. Thank you.
The next gentleman I'm going to bring up is one of our new hires on staff, and we couldn't be more excited to welcome him into the Toledo Rocket family. A gentleman that comes from a breeding background of his father was a head high school football coach in the Youngstown area, played at one of the great college football traditions in Mount Union, won 3 national championships himself as a football player there, 1 as a coach, has hinged his hat on special teams, was an All-American special teams player during his time in Mount Union. Worked in the NFL for a while with the special teams world, and we got a chance to steal him from that place down south, and I couldn't be more excited about him, Coach Stan Watson.
Thanks, Coach. One of the first things that my wife and my daughter did is remove all orange and brown from my house. We had a nice little bonfire out back. On our way down here, but I couldn't be more excited to join a place with that has the vision that this athletic department has, and the vision of this head coach, and the direction that this place is going. I can't tell you how fired up I am to be a part of this program. It was a big year for us in the secondary, losing a couple key guys back there, and I think we did just a fantastic job this offseason here in recruiting. So let me introduce our secondary here in this class, if I could. Okay, Juwan Haynes is a kid from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, Pittsburgh Central Catholic High School. Let me tell you this about Juwan. Some Big Ten teams were flat out after this cat. I mean, they were recruiting him hard, late, and right down to the wire. And I'll say that Jason Candle, the guy that does just a fantastic job in Pittsburgh, I mean, he had this kid pinned down. You know, Juwan felt like he had such a good relationship with the University of Toledo, this staff, and in particular Jason. I quite frankly was a little worried when I got here going into the house, saying, my God, this kid is being recruited quite heavily. I walked in and he's head to toe midnight blue and gold. So just a fantastic job by Jason, and he's a fantastic player as well, and you'll be able to see a couple of clips here.
The past is the past, you know. The past, cause that was yesterday. It's a new day, bro. I'ma put it on my day. You gotta do it now.
Okay, this is an interesting guy here, Travis Neese. He's from Pickle, Ohio, right here in the home state of Ohio. I think the thing that you'll find when you watch this film is that this kid is a tough kid. I mean, he has a knack for getting people down on the ground. Here you go, watch a couple of clips.
Thank you.
Okay, the next guy is Chaz Whitaker from Penn Hills High School, which is a great high school in the Pennsylvania area. I mean, Berry Church, okay, it was from Penn Hills High School, which is a Pennsylvania high school powerhouse. The thing that Chaz brings is great length. You know, I think it's exciting to get a long guy. I mean, he's 6'3", 185 pounds now, and just couldn't be more excited about Chaz. Let's take a look at a couple clips. Okay, and the last guy here is Cameron Cole, a really interesting guy. He's from Fort Scott Community College by way of LaSalle High School in Cincinnati. This was a very highly recruited guy coming out of high school initially in 2010. This is also a guy that in December was on campus at Miami, Florida, all right, on an official visit there. It was at Texas Tech on an official visit. Visited the University of Toledo on his last weekend, okay, and just couldn't say no. Felt like he was a great fit here. Had a great time with the staff. And Cameron Cole, let's take a look. All I do is win, 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 no matter what. Got money on my mind, I can never get enough. And every time I step up in the building, everybody's hands go up. And they stay there. You can see there's some really talented guys in that group. Couldn't be more happy that these four guys are coming to the University of Toledo, and there you have the 2012 secondary class.
Now to offense, and I think one of the things that that I'm most excited about today is I get the opportunity to announce the new offensive coordinator here at the University of Toledo, and one of the great things that I always said about us on offense here at Toledo was never a dictatorship. It was a great room. I think we've got a great staff here on offense, and the guy that'll be the engineer of this offense this year in 2012 is our wide receiver coach, Mr. Jason Candle.
Thanks, Matt. A couple things here first before I get going. I want to first let everybody know that I did decline Coach Took's offer of the makeout session or whatever he was talking about. So don't worry about that. The second thing, I really want to commend Coach Took and Coach Watson for coming in late, you know, and being part of the staff. And I don't think you understand how hard it is to try to mend relationships when coaches leave and they've had strong ties to these kids for 11 months. And these guys on defense came in and did a great job. And Coach Rashid stepped up his game and really helped save this class. So those guys on defense did a fantastic job. Please give them a round of applause. I get the privilege, as always, to sit and talk about the wide receiver class. I think with this year, the departure of Eric Page and the loss of Kenny Stafford, this becomes as vital of a year as any. I want to give out a couple thank yous real quick to Margaret Larkins, Chester Brown, Wendy Miller, Corey Jones Sr., Michelle Jones, Jeff Davis, and Joanna Davis. These are the parents of these four young men that you're about to see right here. The first guy I'm going to introduce to you is Armani Miller from Wayne High School. Armani is about a 6'1", 180-pound guy. Played on a state championship game as a junior. Very fantastic player. Very explosive. You take a look at Armani. The next young man comes to us via Madison Heights High School in Madison Heights, Michigan. He's a three-sport athlete. Danny Larkins goes by DJ. Like Coach Campbell said, was a parade All-American. And the ceiling for this kid is fantastic, and his upside is going to be huge when he gets here and is able to get in a weight room and get in a structured meal program and things like that. And here, take a look at DJ. Third young man, if you kind of follow Rivals and Scout.com, would kind of be one of the headliners of this class. And he's from Penn Hills High School over in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, along with Trayvon Hester and Chaz Whitaker. We kind of hit the trifecta out of that high school. And this guy is equally as talented as other two guys, if not more. And I think what you're going to see on his videotape here is he kind of brings energy and kind of that same style of play of a Bernard Reedy and an Eric Page. It's Corey Jones. Last young man we're going to introduce here at the receiver position is a young man out of Dublin Kaufman High School, a guy that has been to our camp since he was a young kid, kind of work hard guy, and has shown every day that every time he's been here that he's always wanted to be at the University of Toledo. And quite honestly, you know, I could hear it in the kid's voice. He almost teared up when we offered him a scholarship. And I think there's a lot to be said about that. And you can see that this kid brings, what he brings to the table, the passion he plays the game for, is something that all the fans of Toledo are going to be are welcoming him here to see when he does get on our campus, and that's Marcus Davis. Yeah, and I think that's four good guys. I think we're excited about getting them here, and I wish they could be here today and we could start working with them.
The next assistant I'm going to bring up is an old but new face here to the University of Toledo, and this young man has been a graduate assistant here at the University of Toledo during our time here, worked with me on the offensive line, had the great opportunity to go back and be the offensive line coach and offensive coordinator at Mount Union. I had the great privilege of coaching this young man in college, and you wouldn't know it looking at him, but he was a great offensive lineman during his time, Coach Tommy Manning.
First thing, I'm extremely excited to be back here and very grateful for the opportunity. I think this is an unbelievable place, and the things that our administration, our athletic department do are second to none. Secondly, I'd like to recognize the staff that was, you know, intact here throughout the season, okay, and then stayed through the bowl game and recruited this class essentially shorthanded. Coach Campbell, Coach Candle, Coach Ieni, Coach Rashid, Coach Isferning, Coach Chris Hauser. I think all those guys need recognized because what they were able to do is nothing short of amazing. Now, I have the privilege of presenting the offensive line, and anyone that knows Toledo football knows that we've always hung our hat on great offensive lines. And we have a great tradition of offensive linemen that have played in the NFL and have always nurtured the work tough attitude. In this class, I have the privilege of introducing five offensive linemen that we're bringing in. Four signed their national letter of intent today. We have one preferred walk-on that is a tremendous football player. I'd like to begin first with James Henry out of Upper Arlington, out of Columbus, Ohio. This is a young man that addresses some of our needs at the tackle position due to graduation. He's 6'8". He's every bit of 6'8". Extremely a long player. A great kid. A tremendous basketball player. And we're extremely excited about his athleticism and what he brings to the University of Toledo football family. The next young man I have the privilege to introduce is Paul Pershon out of Chicago, Illinois. Paul is you know, a very violent young man in the football field. He's very physical, great player. He has the ability to play both tackle and guard. I know the coaches, you know, they saw him at camp and were very, very impressed with his abilities and what he's able to do. But I think the most impressive thing about Paul is when you go around his school, the things that the people say about him are truly remarkable. He's a tremendous student and an even better kid. So we're extremely excited to welcome Paul Pershon. Next is something that we're extremely proud of. The next man I get introduced is Storm Norton. And anyone that's been around this program understands that Coach Campbell's vision is to keep the best players in Rocket Nation right here in Toledo. And this is a young man that's a homegrown product. He's a tremendous football player. He's even a great basketball player, except that I keep seeing him shoot three-pointers on TV, even though he's 6'8". He likes to play around the arc sometimes. But we're extremely blessed to have Storm here. Storm's a young man that is very athletic for his size, and his upside is through the roof. So we're extremely proud to present Storm Norton. The next young man is named Ray Marlowe. He's out of Dayton, Ohio. He went to Carroll High School. Ray's a big young man. There it says 325. He's every bit of 325 and is a tremendous player. We're really excited to have Raymond, and to know Raymond is to love him. He's got a great smile, a great personality on him, but off the field, but on the field, he's one tough guy. We're extremely happy to have Ray, and everybody around this community will be really happy to have Ray once they see him smile. Last but not least, we have the opportunity to introduce Troy Favorite, who's a homegrown product out of St. John's. He's a fantastic football player, played for a great tradition, great football tradition under Coach Pearson, and we're extremely happy to have him. He allowed us to address some of our needs on the inside and the interior of the offensive line. Let's see a couple clips. As you can see, we have a lot to be proud of on the offensive line, and we're extremely excited to see these young men get here and get to work.
The next gentleman I'm going to bring up is a guy who's been with our program, has done a great job here since the day he's got here. We really owe a lot of credit to, because when I got named the head football coach, he instantly took over the role as the recruiting coordinator here on our campus, and really, we haven't looked back. Scott's done a great job. He's also going to be the engineer of our pass game coordinator. And honestly, I couldn't be more excited to bring up Coach Scott Isferding, our quarterback coach.
Thanks, Coach Campbell. Real quick, and I know we're getting a little crunched for time, please give it up for our staff and for our support staff for the amazing job that they have done. I don't think the support staff gets enough credit in this. This class is amazing when you consider that we were a little shorthanded for a little while. To put this class together is nothing short of amazing, so please. I'm going to get to talk to you about the quarterbacks and also some specialists that we signed this year. Last year, we did not sign a quarterback. So this year, we signed one young man to an NLI and another one as a preferred walk-on, and I think we really hit it out of the park with each of these guys. The first one up is Brian Blackburn, and Brian seems like he's been around here forever. He's been down at camps a number of times. I think he is one of the guys that if you said you could start here tomorrow, he would be the first one in line. He is the unquestioned leader of Detroit Crockett's football team that went deep into the playoffs the last 2 years. You saw by the size of the offensive line, we need to get a quarterback with some size, 6'5", 220 pounds, also runs track at Detroit Crockett. Phenomenal ability. Looking forward to seeing him. It's a guy down at Auburn from a couple of years ago that kind of comes to light when I watch him. I can't wait to coach him. Another guy I can't wait to coach is this young man, Cole French, is coming in as a preferred walk-on, and amazed that he's going to come as a walk-on. He's a special player, the school's leading scorer already in basketball going into his senior year. Had a number of opportunities to play Division II and some Division I opportunities at scholarship levels. Also had some Division I basketball opportunities. We're excited about Cole French. Quickly to special teams. As we said, this next young man is already on campus. Brad Donovan is from down in Texas. Big time leg, and will give us a lot of support in the punt special teams unit. The next two young men are preferred walk-ons that we could not be more excited about having them come to our program. The first young man is Brandon Smith, a local product from here in Toledo that can help us on the punt team and also kickoffs and along with field goals. Lastly, as a long snapper, but was also an all-league center at the powerhouse of Ohio football over there at St. Ignatius, Zach Lozart. Thank you very much.
The last guy I'm going to bring up is really the engine behind our staff. I think he's instant energy. He's the guy that's been the foundation of our great running game and our running backs. And his new title, he's the assistant head football coach here now at the University of Toledo. He's the co-offensive coordinator, deals with our running game, Coach Lewis Iani.
Well, it's an honor, a privilege, and a pleasure to be here. And it's nice to see some familiar faces. You know, us as coaches, we've been on the road for the last couple months scouring the nation for the best and brightest that fit the Toledo mold. And from us as coaches on the road, we want to thank the support staff, Chris, Adam, Nancy, thanks for holding the fort down at home. You know, as we go through this, you know, you look at this class, we're fired up about it, and you got to give a lot of credit to the engineer of it, Coach Matt Campbell, the youngest head coach in college football, with the youngest staff in college football, with the best class in this conference. Good things are coming, okay? Good things are coming. First guy we got, you know, from North Olmsted, Ohio, North Olmsted High School, Mark Remy, and Coach Campbell, when he brought the film to me, he showed me this kid, and the first thing that came to my mind was versatility. All right, first thing he shows me is this kid returned a kickoff for a touchdown. Then he shows me this kid return a punt for a touchdown. Then he shows me him catching a pass for a touchdown. Then he shows me throwing a pass for a touchdown. Then he shows me running as a quarterback for a touchdown. I'm just like, okay, does he play running back? And he's like, oh, yeah. And then he showed me running the ball, and he was a no-brainer. Just watch the film. The next guy comes from Pittsburgh Central Catholic, a traditional power. And, you know, Coach Candle, who recruits that area, he calls me on the cell phone and he says, Lou, I got a sleeper of a great one. You know, and I said, all right, I'm interested. All right. So we had this young man at camp. He was outstanding at camp. I had the privilege to go watch him play a game. And I called Coach Candle immediately. I'm like, Damien just took the first play from scrimmage 80 yards. I called Coach Candle about 5 minutes later, he just caught a pass for 60 yards. I call him again. I'm just like, this dude just scored another 50-yard touchdown. You know, he's not just a sleeper of a great one. He's a showstopper, a headliner. He's really a main event. He's a Ray Rice, Maurice Jones-Drew clone. And I'm really excited. He's the quad A fourth all-time leading rusher of all time, high school Heisman, Damien Dolan. next when you talk about the foundation of Rocket Nation, it starts right here in Toledo. And we made no mistake about it. We're going to recruit Toledo first. And we've had it the last 5 years, the Toledo Blade Player of the Year. This kid's no different. He's had 1,500 yards the last 2 years, over 30 touchdowns. He led Whitmer to the state semifinal. He's going to be a great football player. And we're really excited about him, Jody Webb.
Well, the last young man that I'm going to talk about is our tight end position, and I think one of the great things that we did in this class is we lost two great tight ends in our program, and we were able to replace it with three great ones. And I'm going to start off, and I'm going to start off with the introduction of our first tight end, and the first young man I'm going to talk about is Mike Ebert. Mike Ebert's a big, strong, physical young man from Sandusky Perkins, right down the road here on 75, and he's a guy that's got great talent. He's averaging about 20 points a game in basketball right now, 4.1 GPA, 28 ACT, and he brings to the table a lot of different tools, and we're excited about this young man, Mike Ebert. Next tight end is kind of Mr. Versatile of this class. He's played tight end, he's played wide receiver, he's played running back, he's played quarterback. He's kind of the jack of all trades in this high school. He comes from Marysville High School. He's a young man, again, with a 3.8 GPA. He's a young man that has a 27 on the ACT. He's a sharp young man, but he's an even better football player, great basketball player right now at Marysville, Mr. Craig Runyon. Take a look at Craig. Last but certainly not least is a young man that is a great receiver, a great pass catcher, played a little bit of tight end in high school, but he's truly one of the finest football players in Michigan this year. a young man that, again, himself carries around a 3-4 GPA. He's a great athlete, again, a great basketball player in his own right, Alex Smolik from Port Huron High School in Michigan.
All I do is win, 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 no matter what. Got money on my mind, I can never get enough. And every time I step up in the building, everybody hands go up. And they stay there.
Well, that is the class of 2012, and we could not be more excited to bring these young men and these great student athletes home to Toledo. What a great day for us. Just some closing remarks. The first, I got a couple thank yous, and the first thank you that I want to say is to the guy that really behind the scenes had his hands all over this recruiting class, and that's a young man named Chris Hauser. He's our director of high school relations, and Chris is the behind the scene guy. So let's please give it up for Coach Chris Hauser. Chris really was the engineer behind this class and did a great job. He did all the behind-the-scenes work. He was the guy that shuffled all the recruiting weekends and a guy that stood up when he had to and really is the guy that's at the forefront of this class. A couple other thank yous. First of all, to our athletic director, Mr. Mike O'Brien. Not many athletic directors across the country would be at every one of our recruiting weekends and be a part of the entire process, but he did a great job. And without him and without his support, I know we wouldn't have the great class that we had, Mr. Mike O'Brien. I got a couple key behind-the-scenes people that are awesome for us. I'm going to say them real quick. Miss Nancy Frazier, Miss Stacy Bowers, and Miss Laura Johnson, and our academic office, are sitting right here. Without them, we wouldn't be where we're at. Miss Tammy Nicely, Mr. Brian Lutz, Mr. Adam Salon, who I know is over here right now. Our two graduate assistants, again, two great behind-the-scenes guys. Our new offensive graduate assistant, give a hand, Mr. Nate Cole, one of the great Toledo Rockets. And Coach Daniel Ift, who's done a great job, Coach Daniel Ift. I'd like to say one of our good recruiting assistants, Brian Kenny. I don't know if Brian's here. John Walters, okay, one of our key sports administrative people, Mr. John Walters. And Mr. Rudy Wade. Rudy Wade, our strength and conditioning coach, the best darn strength and conditioning coach in America. Two key behind-the-scenes people, Mr. John Crawford and Mr. David Sankovich. Both of those are our video guys who did a great job putting this together. Let's give them a quick hand. Coach Chuck Pratt, one of our great assistants over here. And finally, Mr. Tim Orga. Tim Orga, our facilities director, did a great job, came in on the weekends, didn't have to. Tim Orga. And the last but not least, let me give it up for Coach Cullop. Let us get the heck out of here and let's get the best darn women's basketball team in the country here. So hopefully you guys are staying. Rockin' Nation is alive and well. Thank you for your support. We can't wait to see you in 2012. Thank you.
Thank you. Baby, it's payday. Let's get it.
They make black plays. We shoot rockets.
Rock out now. We're gonna rock. Go!
Bumps throws toward the end zone. Caught for a touchdown by Bernard Reedy. Touchdown! Rockets, 17 yards. Adonis Thomas with a huge hole around left end to the 30, 20, 50, 10, 5, touchdown! Rockets! Adonis Thomas takes it home.
Wow.
Jefferson pitches it to Clark. He's taken down. Classic assignment football. Desmond Merrill.
Grabbed at the 13-yard line by Page. Straight up the middle, and he's got a hole. Page with running room, still on his feet, and now it's going to be a foot race down the field to the 30, 20, 50, 10, 5. Touchdown! Rockets! Owens gets a snap, throws over the middle, got a man open, that's Reedy, and it's a foot race, Reedy's going to take it in for the touchdown! Backpedals, looks, throws deep over the middle and through the hand to the 10 to target, and intercepted by Jermaine Robinson to the 20. Robinson could take it all the way to the 10, angles to the goal line, and he's in for his second interception return for a touchdown in back-to-back ball games. Touchdown, Rockets! Throwing, completing, and that's Bernard Reedy, who loses a tackle at the 25 to the 15. He's still on his feet, and he scores!